Hey folks, and welcome back once more. Let's play Islands of the Caliph today. New island. There's an underwater area that we're not dealing with, at least not yet. Are these olives? Yes, they are. I think somebody wanted olives, didn't they? Are y'all hiding back here? There's gotta be something. Aha! Really? 180 silver coins and some bandages, which... there are three of them? I mean, I guess why not? I'll take all three that should have stacked in here, hopefully? Yes, awesome. Alright, I mean, they'll be used. So I shouldn't really complain. I'm pleased with the money, though. Do I have blisters? Oh, I'm starving to death. Potato! I'm also apparently extremely tired. Do we know... I have no idea where Critter Lady is, so we're just gonna slip back into town. Because I believe... yes, the inn is like right here. Convenient. Alrighty then, let's get back out and doing violence against scorpions. Okay, what do we got? Where were we? I think we were up here. Is there any fish? Tuna? No? No. Alright. Okay, so that's most of this. Come back around. Just make sure. Not really missing anything. Again, this music really, really reminds me of Lands of Lore 2. Which, generally speaking, isn't a particularly good game to be reminded of. I'm not a huge fan. I think the transformation mechanic in that game completely ruined it. That and them feeling the need to go with the full motion video bullshit that was the fad at the time. And we don't talk about Lands of Lore 3. Mostly because I've never actually played it. I've watched a couple playthroughs of it, but I've never actually played it. Just purely based on the voice acting that I've seen, I think it would annoy me. Alright, so there's nothing in here. Don't think. No. No? No. Fish. This is like, this reminds me of the Hualien jungle in Lands of Lore 2 mixed with like the swamp, like Act 3 from Diablo 2. And then the music changed. Oh, hey. Oh, hey. Oh, hey. We're good. We're good. I love that we've been playing this as long as we have, and I think outside of me showing the mechanic, I don't think I've, like, blocked at all. The combat dance is just, it's just too powerful. Okay, so what do we have here? Hut is empty, but there's a plaque on the door. It says this is the last known dwelling of the legendary explorer Ibn Manjun. Most believe he died long ago. There are rumors that he actually dwells on the Tazkiya archipelago to this day. Huh. Alright, surely I will remember that. Honestly, I think it... I would find it cool if... So we found his hut, right? Nothing else in the game references him. It's just like a little interesting sight to find and that's it. I don't know. I'm okay with games just having locations that are all about the lore in them. It's not something that most games do anymore. Partially, I understand it's because games are much more expensive to produce than they were like back in like the 90s or whatever. So I think a lot of developers feel that, you know, any area that they're dumping development time, development resources into, it should have some meaningful bearing on the gameplay, which, I mean, yeah, that's not wrong, I don't think. But it does kind of suck that, by and large, every area in games is, you know, it's got to serve some function towards, you know, something gameplay related, whether or not it's like a quest or something story related, that kind of thing. Not all games do it, of course. I mean, hell, even Pathfinder Kingmaker, and I suppose to a lesser extent Wrath of the Righteous, they had a bunch of side areas in them where it's just, you know, here's a cave. It's got rat men in it that inexplicably have a dozen rogue levels and are gonna gank your party the first time you come in, but hey, it's just a cave, man. Nothing beyond that, just, you know, a couple rooms and some combat. Man, I guess we're gonna go underwater, but I need to go back to town because we're tired again. And if we're going to explore, I would like to do so while we're awake. We're probably gonna be like starving now. I'm hungry. Potato. We have 5 foods left. I think we'll be okay. Is it ever anything but night here? That's weird. I thought that thing did its death animation and then it didn't. Video games. And save. Let's see what's underwater. Oh, forced scan lines on the gameplay are just terrible. Welcome to Marjan Reef. Yeah, there are certainly squids. Hello, squid. Our mother told us about you. She told of your great act of heroism and how we owe you our lives to your efforts. Our home is yours. Please feel free to stay. Oh, so I'm curious if you, I don't even know if you can, like, do combat against their mother in the beginning or not. It's good to see you, squid friend. You earned this title when you helped our mother. She is no longer with us. Aww. But know that she always remembered you. I'm not sure if this information will help you, but there's a volcano on Asad Island. Yeah, we know that. Minhaj Island used to be a volcano, and it's known for its great iron deposits. Seems like there might be a connection between the volcanoes and iron. Oh, but what do I know? Okay. So then apparently us finding iron, I thought it was on that other island, but I guess it'll be somewhere else. All right, I'm gonna talk to you one more time because I want to write that down. Where's my paper? There's my paper. All right. Let's see. Volcano on Asad Island. Alright. Minhaj used to be a volcano that's known for its iron deposits. Alright, solution for Minhaj. Question mark. Alright, there we go. Well, this is why we're off fucking about doing different things. Oh, hey, some loot. Our mother was always appreciative of your help. She spent much of her life collecting things. She said one day you might come and that you might be in need. On that day, she said we should offer you any of the things she found you. They're all here in these chests for your convenience. Look in the chest, yes. 130 silver coins. Snake elixir, always useful. An exceptional jambia knife, it's worth some money. Stomach medicine, sure. And the oil, I'm gonna pass on. Our mother told us many things. Once she was caught on a hook by a strange fisherman. He was kind, but rather upset about something. He spoke of a strange subterranean tunnel that he took from the Isle of Hikma to Minhaj. Oh, really? All right, writing this down too. Tunnel from Hikma. To Minhaj. Alright, it was filled with terror and darkness. He said no one believed him, but he found something of great importance at the end of that tunnel. Ooh, okay. It was a long time ago, but I do have some memories of that time. I remember seeing you and being scared. But when you returned us to our mother, I knew I had misjudged you. Mother always said you might visit here. I consider you a true friend. We're squid bro, guys. We got squid bros. We thank you truly for your assistance when we were but helpless eggs. Our mother told us to return the favor when we could. All I can offer is information. A small pond on the island of Iklas holds a precious secret. Small pond on Iklas. Holds secret. I think we already knew that. Oh, more loot. We got fair quality, shoddy quality, universal anti-venom, the good shit. Here lies Mama Squid. Oh my god. She always remembered the hero who rescued her babies, and she raised 7 wonderful squids here in the Marjan Reef. Weren't there 8 of them, though? The hero has come! Please, do make yourself at home. Take anything you need. What's ours is yours. Well, I mean... Alright, another 130. Oh, man. We were hurting a little bit on money there, but now we're... once more flush. Okay, well, hey, that was... Oh! Nice try, game. Hiding snake elixirs from me. Okay, well, hey, this was helpful in that it got us some information. Sure. Why would you put a tree here? It's such a pain in the ass, good lord. Okay, let's dump this. So, I think maybe Critter Part Lady's in town. I'm not seeing her on the map, unless that's her to the north. It might be, that might be the Rock of the Rock. Yeah, it's the Rock of the Rock. All right, shows up as an NPC. Very interesting. Okay, all right, Critter Bits Lady. I know you're in here somewhere. No, that's the old power. Weapons, we have things to sell you. Do you have anything I care about? Not really. Okay, come back to the medicine guy. I'm gonna sell snake elixirs. Additional snake elixirs. The universal anti-venom. I'm gonna sell them, because otherwise I'm just gonna hold on to them and never use them. Okay, wow, 1,000 coins. We're pretty comfy. What's this? This whole sign area that I just completely missed like a dope. I'm the local sewer man. Someone has got to do the dirty work. And that just happens to be me. I haven't been able to do much since the rats moved in, though. So they're crawling with the thing, so I don't recommend going down there unless you can help clear them out. In that case, you'll need the agate key. Only Hadia Cube has authority to give that. Good luck talking to him, though. He's so busy dealing with official matters, you may have to get another Sultan to talk to him for you. You don't even mention the old library to him. He'll not talk about it. Frankly, I think there's something fishy going on in that old library. I think the Kadi is afraid of it, and that is why it has barred the gates. But as a sewer man, I know there are ways around this city that most people are not willing to take, if you catch my drift. Alright, so to get the areas we need the key from the Sultan here, I assume? Yes. And he won't talk to us because we're not on official business yet. That comes eventually. Alright, it's up here. Okay, you're the undersea guy. It's good to hear that you were able to use the helmet. Truly, I feel like being able to help you has been better than fulfilling my own curiosity. The squids must have been magnificent. They were pretty great. They gave me, like, a king's ransom in gold, dude. Here we go. Alright, do you have any fish? No. We do have a tuna. That is our precious tuna of fast travel. We can't just vendor that. We don't go into the mosque. We have nothing to do there at the moment. Okay, so... we do not have the package. I think we're ready to level, aren't we? Yeah, we have strength points. But I don't recall what towns that's at, so I'm not going to worry about it right now. Alright, so, there's a tunnel from the island of Hikma to Minhaj. Where's Minhaj? I see Hikma. What direction is Minhaj, though? What the hell is... oh, wow, okay. That's a hell of a tunnel, then. Because, I mean, Hikma's in the center on this chunk of map, and Minhaj is way the hell to the north. Hell would that be? I wonder if that tunnel is what's behind that one huge door in the ghoul village. We go down that tunnel and it pops us up in that temple building in the center of Minhaj. I bet that's what it is. All right, what else do we have? Volcano on Assad Island, which is it's Mount Nar. That's a place with the... I think I know where that is. I think there's that cave that I don't think we ever actually explored. All right. Well, then I think our next goal is going to be Assad Island. Alright, let's summon the bird, bro. I require tree. Thank you. Put our campfire out. Alright. Take me to Assad Island. Have arrived. What's up, Popo? Drop the arrows. Yeah, that was... okay. We could stick our noses into the great and terrible valley of the Manticore and murder hobo all of them again. We're fucking tired. Of course we're tired. It wouldn't be Islands of the Caliph if we weren't tired and hungry and, like, gnawing our own dicks off every time we get hungry. Lord. I'm out of potatoes. Not a happy camper about that. Yeah, that was, like, over here. Somewhere. But I recall... I think we, like, stuck our noses into it, and then I wussed out because we were, like, super tired. Of course you poisoned me. We were, like, super tired, and I didn't want to deal with it. And I was just like, fuck it, no, I'm not going to explore this place while you know, hyper fatigued. And it's like, over here? Yeah. Okay, we're in here now. Oh, would you look at that? Some strange iron-bearing rocks. Clearly I am a genius, and all it took was Squid Mommy to help us out. Man, we did one good deed at the beginning of the game, and it just... I wonder if you can actually fight that squid. And if you do, how that goes. So I assume these are not stacking. Yes, of course. What? No, why would they stack? Silly me. All right, so we're at 4. 5, I believe he wanted 10? Yes. Well, now there's one out in the lava. How the hell? Game, don't you fucking do it. Tease me and let me get like all but like one I need. Oh man. I'd be saying words. Did get this video's monetization limited like all of my Let's Stick Around videos do now. Because apparently you're not supposed to like cuss within the first 30 seconds of your videos. Which, I mean, that's fine. I generally don't start cussing until several minutes into most of my videos as a rule. But apparently the phrase dick, well, I shouldn't say the phrase, the word dick now sets off YouTube's algorithm. And I have tried appealing it and been told no. Ow. I've been told no, you can't appeal that. So now my Let's Stick Around videos are no longer financially incentivized, which I mean naturally means I'm going to have to shutter the series, never recording anything of it again, and turning into a bitter vet. More realistically, I'll just start, instead of saying welcome to Let's Stick Around, it'll be... I'm a genius. It'll just be, I'll just call it like LDA or something. I didn't even notice the lava's like rising and lowering. That's fucking cool. Oh, that's like freaking ingenious. Except I don't know where I'm supposed to go. Oh yeah, I do. Oh, I like that. And it's nothing crazy or anything, but that's just so cool. I was just figuring we were gonna have to be running through the lava and blowing a bunch of bandages or something. You know, it turns out I don't have to hook my guys' feet into tiny little charred nubbins. It's totally fine. I quite like the music here, actually. Oh! Misaligned wall texture! For shame! I gotta call it out. I can't. It's like Captain Planet's throwing fits about misaligned textures in Doom Wads. I just have to. Every game has the issue. Like, any game that has, you know, non-flat plane terrain that's, like, crazy boring is gonna bump into that. Oh, we've actually gotten... We're at 11 iron ore. We're, of course, tired again because what else is new? That's right, I'm gonna go big. We're gonna bring all of the ore back. Looks like 13. And I need to get the hell out of here. Except there might be more. Oh, there's like... Ooh. Dangerous side areas? I mean, I can't say no. Those little fireballs that come out of the ground and move, you can see them on the mini-map. Sliding around, that's cute. I love it. Oh my god. It's adorable. What are you guys hiding back here? I'm getting tired. Oh! 55 silver coins. Bandages. Yeah, I'm gonna take those, and we're actually gonna use those. Because we mildly cooked our feeties in the lava earlier. I'm gonna be burning them again. Probably momentarily here. I think there's another set of stairs to our right. I thought so, but I didn't want to risk just blindly stepping out into the lava. Oh, and there's more. Oh, is this just... Oh, this just gets... Oh my god, that's so fun. This area? Very cool. Very, very cool. And snakes! Yeah, that was... That was just the right amount of... Oh, what the fuck are you? That's new. What's up, buddy? You got some hit points on you. Good god. Oh, what is that? Fucker dropped a glaive. Alright, we're satiated. Let's drop this. What's this? A serpent glaive. Oh! 23 to 32. Alright. Oh, and it's fast. It's like a spear. Alright, cool. I'm all for this. I wonder if that was a spawn related to me going through and looting all the iron, and now we're gonna not be able to keep this thing. You know what I love in video games? You kill an enemy and you get its shit. Extremely tired. Yeah, this thing is fast. Holy crap. Okay, alright. It's the Isle of Iman. I think that's where we want to go, isn't it? Almost. We want to go from Iman to Minhaj, but it's okay, there's a town here. I was going to say we'll sleep, but no, I don't need to sleep. Never mind, we'll just boat. Aw, man. Pole arms are a weapon that I don't think get used in enough games. And somebody mentioned it in the comments that spears are theoretically going to be better than swords in this. And I fucking love it, because spears are better than swords. The only downside is we can't take out trees or rocks with them. But no, spears, like, fucking great. Love it. They get the short end of the stick, pardon the pun, in most games. South? I want to go... See, I almost took the wrong area. But no, like, oh, spears are such a good weapon. Because they're basically a sword, but on a long stick. It's great. You have all the everything. But yeah, it's nice to see a game that's kind of doing them justice. All right. So my thinking is we'll probably do this here. And when we turn this in, then we're gonna have to go to the island that we were just at. Part of the south. Which means, do you have fish? You don't, you got fuzzy balls and radishes. Plav Kalash. Hey buddy. Wonderful, you have found the iron ore so we can produce steel. I'll send a team of miners to that location. We'll be able to make exceptional steel weapons and armor again. Also respond to the Sultan's letter as you requested. Peace be upon you. 150 silver, hell yeah. Okay, so what I want to do, I want to leave, and I want to come back in. And I want to find the weapon shop. Best weapons on the island. I want to see if they have better stuff. It doesn't, well, I mean, they have an exceptional sham shear, but their other stuff looks pretty tame comparatively. My thinking is that given time, they're eventually probably going to be stocking some good shit. How many olives do I need for that guy? 10. And he's a pirate. Fuck that guy. I think pirates are good for us hanging. There. Inventory realigned. Okay, now... Take the... I can't turn down free food. It's just like... As an American, it's against my religion. So the one thing that I absolutely do not want to do is sail all the way back to Shifa. Well, actually not that bad, now that I look at it. Well, kind of is. 1, 2. Yeah, it's 2. All right, we'll sail. It's realistically, it's gonna be quicker to sail than it will be to go fucking about and finding a tuna. I understand that they had to limit the fast travel somehow, because otherwise you would just always do it instead of the boats. But man, kind of sucks. Man, this thing is good. So this time, we want to go this way. It would be nice if there were like, I don't know, once you'd been to the islands, you could just pay to go from one island to another and skip all of the walking and the boat rides. Charge me all the money to go from A to B, sure. Or A to B to C to D, whatever it happens to be. Just save me having to deal with all this shit. Is it the island of Hikmah? Yes. The first time you sail to an island, it's novel because you get to come in and you get to see, oh, look at this new area that we're going to get to putter about in. Once you've been doing it for about 6 hours, 8 hours, it kind of loses the novelty. Hey, fish man, you got any tuna? I don't remember what they look like. That's a carp. You have a tuna. Thank you, sir. Oh. Okay, well, that'll be a fast travel that we'll be able to use to somewhere at some point in time. Yeah, this thing attacks fast enough that I can swing on those things twice before they hit me. That's pretty good. Yeah, that's really good. That means we can fight those, we can fight spiders. I think we fight green spiders. And I don't have to worry about dancing with them. We can just flat out kill them. Hey, tuna? No, you don't. I always see these, the carp, and think that they're tuna. They're not. You sell tendies. I do like me some tendies. Holy shit, that coconut. Sold. Man, why tendies gotta be so expensive? I do love tendies. Okay, carrots. I want. I cannot turn down the tendy. You give me some delicious nugs and I am like all over that. It just channels directly into me being a 5-year-old mentally. The help you provided to Abdul Kawi will benefit us all. The iron you found will help us all forge stronger armor and weapons of steel. Moving forward, please take this next letter to Sultan Ahmed. As you know, he resides on Sadaka Town to the west. I am pleased that he has already made great changes there, establishing the pillar of zakat and charity among his people, as the Quran commands. Please, bring this letter to him in my name. Will you help me once again? Yes. Sadaka Town was ever an ally in the past, so I expect he will respond well. I need his help if we are to unite the islands and establish justice and balance. Go to Sadaka Town, see if the Sultan Ahmed is ready. Thank you again for your efforts. Alright, I wasn't expecting to go back to Babby Bird, but I mean, sure, why not? This should be easy. How bad could it be? Am I starving or tired? Extremely hungry. Tendies devoured. Okay, so Sadaka Island, I think that's the southern one? Yes. So we are kind of forced into having to rebuild this if we do the evil. Oh man, imagine if you like just fucked all your money off and were like, I don't care about this bitch, and you were broke and you had to earn like 1,000 gold pieces running around doing busy work like breaking barrels and killing rats. Ew. On that note though, I think I'm going ahead and call it an episode here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. I'll see you all next time when the adventure continues. Till then. Hey, you made it to the end. Nice. If you had a good time, check out one of these other series, see if you like them. Drop a like, comment, or subscribe if you'd like to support the channel, via the machine and all that. As always, thanks for watching.